What is going on, everybody? Happy April. Welcome back to my channel. I am your girl, Jay Jones, and I know it's been a minute, but I'm back, okay? I'm back. It's gonna be great, guys. 2020, I got a lot to share. I got a lot to update you on. If you all wanna know what's been going on with your girl, all about my chastity update, stay tuned. Welcome to my channel. Listen, I know I've been gone. I know I haven't been consistent, but it's gonna be great. Don't judge me, okay? I got busy. I launched my J Juice business this year, / kind of the end of last year. I was made the new choreographer for Woe Worship at World Overcomers, my church. Just been given a lot more responsibilities towards the end of the last year, and also got a little sidetracked, got a little distracted, but I'm gonna get into that later on in the video. But that's no excuse, guys. I love you all. I love getting up here. I love being real with you all, being transparent, sharing my perspective, and helping you all gain a little bit more wisdom with me while I'm on this walk and this journey, especially spiritually. So I know y'all all want to know if I fumbled the ball. If I jump head in or whatnot, what's been going on? What's your chastity journey? That's the question, right? That's what everybody been thinking. That's what everybody want to know. Did Jessica slip up? All right. I'm going to be real with y'all. I don't know how they do it on anybody else's channel. I don't know if other YouTubers who talk about their chastity journey or who are open about what they have going on sexually or whatnot, if they be lying or what. But temptation is real. And if your flesh is not in the right place, if you are not strong enough, guys, you're gonna fail every time, okay? I've learned a lot in the last couple of months of the year. You know, shenanigans happen. And you're gonna front, okay? But I was convicted a little bit. My best friend hit me up early part of the week and was like, yo, when you gonna post a video? You ain't posted a YouTube. I had a couple of people who, teenagers who follow me. I'm gonna be doing a little bit more this year in regards to you all and how I want y'all to stay focused and keep your virginity. Also, some people who are like walking on, you know, working on their chastity journey reached out to me and was like, you know, your chastity walk was helping me so much. And, you know, I started mine 2 months ago. Somebody who I ran into that goes to church with me started her chastity journey. I need to check on her a couple of months ago as well. So I didn't realize that me doing these videos was so helpful and was such a good impact. So here we are, 2020. I got you. We gonna continue our journey together. And all of us are on a different walk, on a different path, on a different journey. So we can't compare stories, but I can be here and be transparent and help you all with some of my mistakes and some of the things that I found out that have been helpful for me as I continue on my chastity journey, all right? So here's the dun the dun, all right? 10 months in, your girl jacked up. Your girl came to her flesh, all right? And that's not an excuse for you all to go and mess up. Not an excuse, all right? Still gotta stay focused, all right? Learn from my mistakes, guys, all right? Don't do it. It's not worth it. And it wasn't no easy little, you know, like, setup or whatnot. You know, like, the one thing that I know for a fact is that the enemy knew that he was gonna have to come with it, okay? Like, he knew that he couldn't just throw any old, you know, person at me. Like, I wasn't gonna fail those little easy tests or whatnot, you know, like, at 6 months, you know, I had some dudes that was at me like, you know, so and so, it's been 6 months. I was like, you think you gonna get it? 7 months, you think you get it? 8 months, you think, 10 months? Okay, so the devil knew he had to bring it. He had to come with it. He brought somebody from my past. okay? I mean, way back from my past. He dig deep for this one, all right? Somebody that I had history with that knew me when I was a virgin, okay? Like, that's the funny part. The funny part is when I met this guy, I was a virgin. I was very, very much, you know, like, really, really serious about my virginity when I was growing up. People who know me know I didn't start having sex until I was... I lost my virginity when I was 18, but I really didn't start having sex, like, sex life until I was 19, until I got to college. And so, he knew. He knew. And it's so crazy because this guy, he pursued me when I was 15. He was about 16. And, I told him I wasn't with it, you know what I'm saying? Like, he was like, so I'm saying, you know, you my girl and everything, so you gonna let me in? I was like, no, why would I do that? I'm not giving my virginity up to you. You know, I was very, very serious about it, so serious to the point where I told him, even, I was like, matter of fact, knowing that that's something that you want out of your girlfriend, you know, we probably shouldn't be together. You should probably be dating someone who is on the same level as you because you're not getting it. I mean, feel me? And so we even, you know, I severed ties with him then and was very serious about, you know, when I was that young, being a virgin to me was like something that was like sacred. I held it close, you know. People were doing it already, so I just felt like, no, I don't want to do it because everybody is doing it. One, it's common. And then two, my mama told me that I was going to get pregnant as soon as I did it. So that scared the heck out of me in the front. And then three, I was so involved spiritually with God. And I was in, you know, youth ministry growing up. You know, I had a different connection then, you know, spiritually. So I just was really, really serious about not having sex or whatnot. And you can't miss something that you ain't ever had. So, you know, that's just what it was. And then I went on to date a guy who I'm still really good friends with, after that for like 2 years and no sex, you know. So it was very possible for me to be in a relationship at that age and not be sexually active. For all of my people out there who are teenagers who are watching this or whatnot, it's very possible for you to keep your virginity and be in relationships with people, okay? You can do it. It's possible. But nonetheless, he pulled somebody from my past, you know what I'm saying? Because eventually me and that guy did link back up and we did have somewhat of a relationship together. So flesh got weak. Flesh got weak, but it's all good. You know, the enemy will set you up or whatnot for failure, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, he had to come with it. He had to be somebody who he knew I was going to, like, fold like a deck of cards for, and he had to set it up in a scenario that made sense to me, that made it look like it was going to go somewhere. I linked back up with this guy at a church event, guys. At a church event, I ran into this guy, okay? So, for me, it was like, oh, he at church, I'm at church. You know, I was out, I was volunteering at an event for church, okay? I'm roof out in the field with it, you know what I'm saying? He ain't no Boaz, but, you know, we was in the field. And anyways, if y'all don't know about roof and Boaz, we'll talk about that later. But I'm roof out there in the field. I'm working, I'm volunteering, you know, I was at a real love conference that my church was having. And so the whole weekend was centered around love, you know what I'm saying? And so for me, it was crazy because I was like, dang, I ain't seen this man in so long. I'm wrong, because the Holy Spirit convicted me immediately and was like, don't do it, sis. And I still was like, but what? Not again. I wanted to see how you doing. You know, like, he still looks good. He still looked that same. He yummy. She like, no. And I'm like, all right. And then I still was like, I'm going to see that. Little see how you doing, little small talk turned into let's link up. I was actually on my way out of town with my sister for my birthday weekend. Linked up with him when I got back in town, had a couple of drinks, got to reminiscing. All she wrote, guys. So there it is. And even though I did fail at keeping my chastity or whatnot, I learned a lot. I learned a lot from the situation, from the experience. One of the things that I learned is that time is everything, guys. Time is everything. And I was not going to do the same thing that I did in my previous relationships with people with this situation. Even though I had already messed up by giving my flesh the win or whatnot, I knew from Jump Street that I was going to go into this situation with expectation. I was like, God, forgive me for what I've already done. Okay, help me with this. Continue to, you know, walk with me, talk with me daily on how I can really sift out if this is somebody that I need to be pursuing or if this is somebody that I need to just. So I went into the situation already with an expectation, like, okay, if I don't see this in the next month, if I don't see this by the end of the year, if I don't see this in 90 days, then it's pretty much a wrap, you know, because I know what I am. I'm a wife. And I know that I want to be someone's wife. I know I want someone to present me to the altar without spot, blemish, or wrinkle. And that's it, period, point blank, okay? I'm somebody's wife. So, when I was dealing with this guy or whatnot, you know, I knew eventually that I would start to see some of his flaws, some of his imperfections come out. And that's okay because we're all not perfect. But imperfections and inconsistency, two different things, guys. And you got to know the difference, okay? So, 1 month or 2 months in, I started seeing a flag here. Flag there. About 2-3 months in, flag there. About 3-4 months, flag on the plate. Run it back. Run it back. Did you really think that you was gonna do that? And that we was gonna keep talking? Okay, so this individual lasted for about 4 months, okay? And I was very serious. He knew what the expectation was with me going in. You know, I told him, I was like, listen, I wanna be a wife. I wanna be courted. I wanna be pursued. I want to be with somebody who compliments me. I want to be with somebody who supports me. I want to be with somebody not only who, you know, who we can, because the one thing that I loved about this guy that I still adore about him is that we can talk for hours about anything. We can talk about spirituality. We can talk about sports. We can talk about entertainment. We can talk about vibrations, law of attraction. We can talk about anything. I mean, pillow talk is a thing with this guy. And time just goes by with him. But don't get caught up in the mirage. Don't get caught up in the daydream or whatnot. And you miss what's happening around you, okay? Like, there was so much stuff that we would do when we were together that was so great. But there were so many other things that were so inconsistent, so wishy-washy, so, you know, like, how we talk on the phone for a whole month and then the next month you don't want to talk consistently. How we go on a couple of dates the first month, but then you don't want to go out and do nothing. How we talking about, you know, pursuing, you know, a relationship together, but then you still showing up places with your ex. Those were types of things that were happening, red flag on the play, and I wasn't getting ready to be blindsided or play or waste more time just because I'm sexually active with you. No, we're not gonna do that or whatnot. Use wisdom, guys. Be smart. And I was trying to use wisdom. I was really trying not to get caught up in a situation that only should have lasted a couple of months for a couple of years. Because I don't have that type of time. I'm someone's wife. Remember, I have a goal. I have an expectation. So when you know, when you're not meeting the expectation, when I'm not seeing any fruit being bared from this, it was very easy for me to cut him off and give him the deuces and walk away, okay? And that's exactly what I did January the 1st. And it's been on and popping since, guys. Flourishing like no other. The relationship that I have with God is so amazing. God, Holy Spirit talking to me on a daily basis. I mean, like, overflow, vibration, my relationships with people is just crazy. How 2020, even with quarantine, even with all the shenanigans going on with Corona, is happening. How amazing life is right now, okay? So we're going to get into all of this. We're going to dive deeper into the shenanigans. I just wanted to get up here and let y'all know a little bit of what happened, guys. You know, and like I said before, this is not an excuse to go and mess up. You know what I'm saying? Like, learn from my mistakes or whatnot. If it don't feel right, if it look like a duck, quack like a duck, it's a duck. If it look like it's too good to be true, it probably is too good to be true, guys. You know, really know, really take the time to, you know, like, figure out if this is somebody that you want to do something with, because some people aren't as strong enough in their self to know what they want and stick to their guns, okay? Like, when I cut this man off, he was very, very consistent and persistent about texting me, calling me, trying to figure out different ways to connect with me, to see me, so that we could talk about it, so he could give his side of the story, so that we could, you know, work on how we could fix this and be together. You know, it was a lot of that going on, but it took me a month to really sever ties with this man and really understand, like, no, I really need to cut you off and really go into this with a little bit more clarity and discernment or whatnot about what I want and letting you know what I want, because we've been having sex and sex is glue. And so I really needed to remove the flesh and all emotions from it. And it took me about a month to really get to a place where I was like, oh, okay, if I wanted to talk to him now, I'm clear enough in my flesh and in my conscience to really listen to what he has to say and know if it's a lie or if it's the truth. You know what I'm saying? So you have to be wise, guys. Use wisdom. Learn from my mistakes. All right? I'll be back, guys. If you love this video, make sure you share, like, subscribe to my channel. Hit that little notification button so you can get all my videos in real time. And we'll be here all 2020, guys. Be safe in the quarantine. We're going to get through this. Don't even worry about it. It's going to be great. Love y'all. Till next time.